Hey everyone, this introduction will be a little bit longer as I am starting a series of where I will be creating a multiplayer real-time strategy game in Unity that can be played over the internet like Age of Empires or Warcraft 3, just as an example. I will show step by step what to do and how I delve into the code with finishing a section. In this episode, I will set up the project. Firstly, I'm going to go to Unity Hub. If you don't have Unity Hub, make sure to download and install it in the link below. When you have Unity Hub open, then you want to go to the installs and make sure you have the latest Unity LTS installed by going to add and then select the top recommended release normally and then install. We then want to go back to projects and click on new to create our projects. I will call my project Content Creator Age and then click on Universal Render Pipeline and then click create. When Unity is done loading up, then we can delete the README asset. In the scripts folder, we want to delete the simple camera controller script and then we want to delete the example assets folder as we will be using our own assets and we can also delete the tutorial info folder. In the scene itself, we want to click on the main camera and see that there is missing mono script. We just want to delete that as we deleted it a moment ago. We can click the three dots and then remove component and also delete the example assets game object. Then go to Window and then Package Manager and then go to My Assets to download and import Mirror. If you do not have Mirror as an asset, then make sure to go to the Unity Store link below to add the asset. Make sure it is updated and import. When you import Mirror, make sure to uncheck script templates as you won't need that and import. We also want to go to the Unity registry and make sure we have the following assets installed. First one will be CineMachine and then Input System. And make sure to click yes to restart and that you want to save the scene. Once back in, then Text Mesh Pro. And if you use Visual Studio Code Editor, then make sure to add that asset. One thing that I also came across was a lot of my assets were actually outdated. So make sure to update all your assets. So I'm going to use Polygon Knights Low Poly 3D Art by Cinti. And if you do have your own assets for the game you have in mind, then please import them. Otherwise, just for the tutorial purposes and getting a base project done, use a Cinti Polygon Starter Pack if you don't have any assets to use for now, as that pack is free and will have enough assets. When you imported your assets, then you can do the same as me or not, but I like to create a folder and call it imported assets and drag everything I import into the folder to keep it nice and clean. Because of the fact we are using Universal Render Pipeline, Cinti Assets either has a URP extract me Unity package included in the project files, or you will need to go to Edit, then Render Pipeline, Universal Render Pipeline, and then upgrade project materials to Universal Render Pipeline materials. Next is to identify which prefab will be our player for now. Because we want to implement some of the networking from the start and make sure that two players can see each other. Once you have the player in mind, drag and drop the object in the scene and reset the transform and rename the game object to player. Create a prefab folder in the assets folder and drag and drop the player into the folder and choose original prefab if it was a prefab already. In the scene, we also want to reset the camera transform and place it to where we want it for now. When the basic scene is complete, we want to get the network manager in the scene and make sure that another player can join. Create an empty game object and call it network manager, and then reset the transform. Then add the network manager component and the network manager HUD component to the network manager game object. So one thing that we want working in this section of the project is just that when a new player joins, then it goes on a random spawn point. As you remember, Age of Empires has set spawn points where the players start, so we want to recreate that, but without a UI for now. When using Mirror, you need to assign to each player or unit that is moving a network identity. So on the player game object, we are going to add the component network identity. Once you have done changes to your game object in the scene, then you still need to override all of those changes to the prefab by going to override and then apply all changes. We can then delete the player from the scene, as the player will spawn into the scene by dragging the player prefab into the network manager game object where it says player prefab. Now that we have a player to spawn, now we need some spawn points for these players in the scene. So let's create an empty game object and just call it spawn point and reset the transform. Once the transform has been reset, you can just add any amount on the x-axis just to move the two spawn points away from each other to see if another player spawned at the second spawn point. So for the first spawn point, I will make x equal to 3. Then duplicate the spawn point with Ctrl plus D for Windows. Not sure what it is on Mac, but I'm pretty sure it's Command D or something like that. And then changing the second spawn point to X equal minus 3. You can always use a 3D game object like a sphere just to see the spawn points physically. And once happy with the placement, you can just delete the mesh and colliders on the spawn point. When you are happy with the placement of your two spawn points, then we can add the network start position component on both spawn points. Because this is an RTS game, we want to go to the network manager and where it says player spawn method, change it from random to round robin. Random allows two players to spawn at one position by chance, as it is just randoms between all the spawn points in the scene. Round robin starts from one spawn point and moves to the next spawn point until all spawn points has been used, and then starts from scratch again. A good example will be Call of Duty shipment map. Did you ever find yourself spawning at the same place than the enemy? Well, that is because all of the other spawn points already had a player spawned on, and the first spot where the enemy spawned a second ago got open again. Now that we got spawning out of the way, we want to build and run the game because we're going to test a few times. We want to go to File, then Build Settings, then Player Settings, and then Resolution and Presentation. And under Resolution, next to Full Screen Mode, we just want to change this to Windowed for better testing of more than one client. You can change the default screen width and screen height to personal preference. Make sure in the top it shows the scenes in build, and once all of that is correct, you can build and run the game. If it is your first time building the game, then just create a new folder called builds and go into the folder and select folder. You can make this folder wherever you want. It is not really needed in the project folder, just personal preference. Once the build runs, then the client will pop up with the HUD on the top left. In the Unity Inspector, you can now run the game and click on Host, Server, and Client. This will make the local host active because of the fact that it is on your computer, and once you are spawned into the game, then go to the Running Client window and click Client while it says Local Host in the box. If we look now, we can see both of our players are in the game and next to each other. Subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss more videos helping you with game development in Unity. And make sure to follow this series if you like where it's going. Cheers.